بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, I testify that there is no true God worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is Allah's true slave and messenger. We continue the explanation, or rather the points of benefit deduced from the hadith of Jibreel, the encounter of Jibreel alayhi salam with the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, and the questions and answers that were raised concerning the deen of Allah. And from the points of benefit is that we learn to affirm the existence of the angels, and that it's a must to believe in them. And here we have a question: are the angels human, are the angels of a physical form, or are purely intellectual, and meaning also having no physical form, or are they just powers, or are they just powers? The angels, the correct answer of course is that the angels are without any doubt are bodies, without any doubt, physical, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about them in Surah Fatir 35 verse 1. Allah Azza wa Jal, جَاعِلِ الْمَلَائِكَةِ رُسُلًا أُولِي أَجْنِحَةٍ مَثْنَى وَثُلَاثَ وَرُبَعَ. All the praises and thanks be to Allah, the only originator, or the only creator of the heavens and the earth. And here's the point of evidence: who made the angels messengers with wings, two or three or four. He increases in creation what he wills. Verily Allah is able to do all things. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in the authentic hadith said, attat as-sama, attat, this term atit means quote unquote squeaking. And it is said that when a camel is loaded heavily, then you can hear the squeaking of the heavy load. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam here is referring that the sky quote unquote attat, squeaked, and وحق لها أن طئت, and يعني it's quite deserving that it does so, because ما من موضع أربع أصابع إلا وفيه ملك. There is no place that can accommodate four fingers except that there is an angel standing by before Allah, or bowing, or ساجد, قائم لله أو راكع أو ساجد. And also another evidence that the angels are physical is the hadith of Jibreel that we're talking about now. And also we know also the hadith of Jibreel as well, where there is a description of him, where the Prophet ﷺ saw him, and that he had 600 wings which blocked the horizons. I mean, telling of the magnificence of the creation of Jibreel alayhi salam. And there are abundant evidences for this. As for those who said that they are purely spiritual, not physical, this is wrong and misguided. This is wrong and misguidance. And even worse is the saying that the angels are only symbolic, referring to the powers of goodness which exist in man, and that the devils are also symbolic in the sense that they refer to the evil powers. This is from the worst in falsehood of the sayings. The 16th point of benefit is that لابد من الإيمان بجميع الرسل. It's a must to believe in all the messengers. So if someone believes by his messenger, or yes, someone may believe in his messenger and denies the rest, then indeed he didn't believe in his messenger in the first place. Rather, he is a kafir himself. And read the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concerning the people of Nuh. قال الله تعالى كذبت قوم نوح المرسلين. The people of Nuh belied the messengers with an S. You see, there is a plural there with an S. This is in Surah Al-Shu'ara 26-105. Although مع أنهم إنما كذبوا نوحا, although they only belied Noah, and there was no messenger before Noah. However, belying one single messenger from the messengers is belying the rest, the entire messengers. And also belying one of the books that Allah revealed from him to any of the messengers, then is in itself belying all the books which Allah revealed. The 17th point of benefit, إثبات اليوم الآخر, affirming the last day, الذي هو يوم القيامة, which is the day of the resurrection, or the resurrection day, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will resurrect people for recompense, and the people of Jannah will reside in their abode of Jannah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the residents of Al-Firdaus Al-A'la, and the people of the fire will be in their abode. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us all from the fire of hell. Some of the people who are mushriks, the pagans, denied the resurrection. قال الله عز وجل in Surah Yasin, which is 36 verse 78, وضرب لنا مثلا ونسي خلقه قال من يحيي العظام وهي رميم. And he puts forth for us a parable and forgets his own creation. He says, who will give life to these bones when they have rotted away and became dust? This is the saying of the mushrik. So when these bones are crumble and become rotten, so Allah answered this by commanding his prophet to say in the next verse, قُلْ يُحْيِيهَا الَّذِي أَنْشَأَهَا أَوَّلَ مَرَّةِ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ خَلْقٍ عليم. Verily, the one who brings it to life is the one who أنشأها أول مرة. This will be 78. The verse is who created them for the first time. Yes, and he is the all-knower of every creation. وهو بكل خلق عليم. جزاكم الله خير. So this is evidence, and it being evidence lies in the fact that the one who is able to bring into existence is able to repeat it. وقال الله تعالى in Surah Al-Rum chapter 30 verse 27, قال الله تعالى وهو الذي يبدأ الخلق ثم يعيده وهو أهون عليه. And it is Allah, He who originates the creation, then will repeat it. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. After it has been perished. And this is easier for Him. Naam. So if the initiation of creation is easy, and while you mushriks testify to that, then repeating it is even easier. And all is easy to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the first evidence in response to their denial of the resurrection. The second evidence is in the saying of Allah in the same verse early, وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ خَلْقٍ عَلِيمٌ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ خَلْقٍ عَلِيمٌ. And He is the all-knower of every creation. He knows how He creates and how He ordains His creation. So كيف تقولون إن هذا ممتنع? So how come you say that this is not possible? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Yasin, the same Surah 36 but verse 80, الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمْ, الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمْ, meaning الَّذِي, the one who made for you, those produces for you, أَيُّهَا الْمُنْكِرُونَ, you who deny, and also to others as well, من الشجر الأخضر نارا, produces for you fire out of a green tree. So the meaning of this ayah, that in the Hijaz area, in the western side of Arabia, there were trees and these trees were called al-murkh wal-uffar. Let me write them down. They used to strike these green produce with primitive tool to ignite, and it turns into fire. Although it is wet, moist and green and cool and cold, meaning, you know, far from being something you would think it will produce fire, yet despite of this it does. So the one who is able to create from something its opposite is able to repeat the same thing itself. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Yasin 80, فَإِذَا أَنْتُمْ مِنْهُ تُوْقِدُونَ, then behold, you kindle therewith. And this is something, a testimony against them, because this is not something strange to you, because you use it, you mushriks. You use it to kindle the fire. So it's really something against you. The third evidence, الدليل الثالث, from the evidences in response to those who deny the resurrection, is the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَوَلَيْسَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ, Yasin 80, عليكم السلام, Yasin 80, أَوَلَيْسَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ بِقَادِرٍ عَلَىٰ أَن يَخْلُقَ مِثْلَهُمْ, is not he who created the heavens and the earth able to create the like of them? Then Allah answered, the answer came, yes indeed, bala. Allah answered himself. Allah answered himself by saying bala, yes indeed. Because the creation of the heavens and the earth is much greater than the creation of mankind. قال الله تعالى وهو الخلاق العليم, who is the one who creates and all knowing, the one who brings with perfect creation, with perfect ability, things to existence. إنما أمره, indeed, his command, إذا أراد شيئا, when he intends a thing, أن يقول له كن فيكون, only to say it be and it is. So nothing really stands to oppose or make يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing is impossible for him subhanahu wa ta'ala to create. If he commands something existing to become non-existence, it will become non-existing. Or if something non-existing to become existing, to exist, then it will exist no matter what. And in the story of Musa, in the story of Musa, alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, in the story of Musa, alayhi salam, when he stood by the sea, the deep sea, Allah commanded him to strike the sea, and he did once, and behold, it split and it became dry, 12 dry paths immediately, instantaneously, as in Surah Al-Shu'ara 26 verse 63, فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَىٰ أَنِ اضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْبَحْرَ فَانْفَلَقَ فَصَارَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْضِ الْعَظِيمِ. Then we inspired Musa, Moses, saying, strike the sea with your stick, and it parted, and each separate part of that sea water became like the huge firm mass of a mountain. Can we do this to, is anyone really able to do this to the water? Part it? No one except Allah Azza wa Jal, because if he wants or intends something, he will say to it be and it will be. And here the occasion arises in order to caution against the saying of some common Muslims, where they say, when they invoke Allah, some of them will say, Ya man amruhu bayna al-kafi wal-noon. Okay, so we read in the verse that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends something, he will say to it, Kun. Allah will say to it, Kun. Kun. Okay, so there are three letters, K, U, and N here, okay, for us, but it's really two. Kun, but look at pronunciation, kun, it appears as if there are three letters, but it is K and N, kun, fay, in Arabic. So they invoke Allah and they say, Ya man amruhu, O Allah, the one whose command is between the kaf, K, and the noon, and the N. And this is a great error. And the correct way to say it, if it is to be said, Ya man amruhu ba'da al-kafi wal-noon. O Allah, the one whose command is after the kaf and noon. After the kaf and noon. Why? Because that which is between the kaf and noon is not a command. And the command is not complete until kaf and noon are completed in the saying, because the kaf is not in itself a command, and similarly the noon is not in itself a command. When they come together, they become a command, they become a word, kun, be, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ كُنْ كَافْ نُون بِ it will be فَيَكُون. So what matters now is that we must believe in the last day, even though our weak mental capacity sees this is far from occurring. Why we want to say we want really to believe and we must believe? Because لأن الله تعالى إذا أمر حصل هذا فورا. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he commands this, then it will take place immediately. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Yasin, again 36, but verse 53, إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة, meaning one shout and all the creation will be brought together. It will be a single sayha, shout, and so behold, they will all be brought up before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, the 18th point, that we believe in the pre-decree, it's good and it's bad. And this matter, believing in the pre-decree, is a great battle from the time of the Sahaba, from the time of the companions until our times. We spoke earlier that the belief in the pre-decree has four ranks to it. Can anyone name these ranks? The question now is open. What are the four ranks concerning the belief in the pre-decree? Let's see, inshallah, give some time to motivate our memory. What are the four ranks concerning the Al-Qadr, the pre-decree? What are the four ranks of the belief having faith in the pre-decree? Okay, then let's refresh our memories. Number one, Al-Ilm, knowledge. Second, نعم, writing. Third, المشيئة, will. Fourth, creation. These are the four ranks of Al-Qadr. These are the four ranks of belief in Al-Qadr. Okay, طيب, let's speak about each and every one of them. This means that we believe that Allah Azza wa Jal عالم بكل شيء, knows everything in general and in details regarding his actions, like creating, giving life to the dead, or regarding the actions of his slaves. And there are a lot of evidence for that. قال الله تعالى in Surah Al-Baqarah chapter 2 verse 282, والله بكل شيء عليم. So inshallah next time we're going to ask about these points, and we will ask about evidences as well, meaning if we say that knowledge is one of the ranks in the belief in the in Al-Qadr, in the pre-decree, then we'll ask what is the evidence. The evidence here is now, as you can hear it, the saying of Allah in chapter 2, and there is so many of that in the Quran concerning the knowledge of Allah. 2282, وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. And verily Allah, and He knows everything, all knower of all things. And also He says in Surah Al-Mulk, in Surah Al-Mulk verse 14 as well, in Surah Al-Mulk verse 14, أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Shouldn't He who has created know? And He is the most kind and courteous to His slaves, all aware of everything. Al-Jawab therefore, yes. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, shouldn't He who has created know? Yes. This is in general, this is the general knowledge. Now the detailed knowledge, we can have some evidence from Surah Al-An'am, chapter 6 verse 59. Chapter 6 verse 59. قال الله تعالى وعنده مفاتح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو ويعلم ما في البر والبحر وما تسقط من ورقة إلا يعلمها ولا حبة في ظلمات الأرض ولا رطب ولا يابس إلا في كتاب مبين. And with him are the keys of الغيب, all that is hidden, none knows them but he, and he knows whatever there is on or on the earth, in or on the earth and in the sea. Not a leaf falls but he knows it. There is not a grain in the darkness of the earth, nor anything fresh or dry, but is written in a clear record. This pertains to the detailed knowledge, as you can tell. Now, if someone comes and says, we have a problem, we have a problem, عندنا إشكال. Is everyone now, let us give this really our keen attention, please. There is a problem here. How are we going to understand the following? Like the saying of Allah in Surah Muhammad 47:31. Allah says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ حَتَّى نَعْلَمَ. And surely we shall try you till we... Well, they put the meaning here, they put the meaning, but I will give you the translation of the meaning, where the problem may be realized, and then the tafsir, the interpretation, the correct interpretation will be given. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ. And surely we'll try you, we'll try you, we'll test you, until... لا, 47:31. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ حَتَّى نَعْلَمَ الْمُجَاهِدِينَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّابِرِينَ وَنَبْلُوَ أَخْبَارَكُمْ. And surely we shall try you till we know. Instead of test, let's put know between parentheses. نعلم المجاهدين, those who strive hard for the cause of Allah, and the patient ones, and we shall test your facts. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ حَتَّى نَعْلَمَ, until we know. Okay, as we go with the literal translation of the meaning now, حَتَّى نَعْلَمَ, until we know. Until we know. طيب, think about the issue, think about the problem now. And then also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Ma'idah in chapter 5 verse 94, ليعلم الله من يخافه بالغيب ليعلم الله من يخافه بالغيب ليعلم that Allah knows. Okay, forget about now may test, alright? It's correct, but we'll give you the meaning that the literal meaning whereby it may sound like a problem. لِيَعْلَمَ, you know, يَعْلَم means to know, okay? So that we know, لِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ, so that Allah knows, مَنْ يَخَافُهُ بِالْغَيْبِ, okay? Who fears him in the unseen. Okay, great. Also take, for example, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 142. Chapter 3, verse 142. أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَمْ تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمَّا يَعْلَمِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا مِنْكُمْ وَيَعْلَمَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Okay, also another issue, another problem. All revolving around the same problem, which we will now shed the light on it, inshallah ta'ala. أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَنْ تَدْخُلُوا, do you think that you will enter paradise before Allah knows? Look at this. Are you beginning to sense where we are going now concerning this mushkil? Before Allah knows those of you who fought in his cause, and also knows those who are as sabreen, patient. Maybe Sister Ahmad remembers the other day somebody came to the room and he said, before Allah, when a term in a verse like this, until Allah knows, or before Allah knows, and then they raised the issue and they said, what's wrong here? The problem is the apparent, na'am, the apparent meaning here is as if the knowledge of Allah is renewable after the occurrence of the action. After the occurrence of the action, now you're beginning to sense the issue. Are you following, inshallah, with me? And how about the rest? Okay, more. I want to know if some. Okay, all right, mashallah, alhamdulillah. Now the answer for this apparent problem is from one of the following two angles. Naam. Until they occur. You see, until after they occur. So as if the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is tatajaddad, renewable. The first angle, as an answer, that the knowledge of Allah Azza wa Jal after its occurrence is not his knowledge, la, inna ilm Allah Azza wa Jal, the knowledge of Allah Azza wa Jal after the occurrence is not his knowledge concerning it before it takes place. Why? Because his knowledge before its occurrence is his knowledge that it will occur, and his knowledge after its occurrence is knowledge that it is occurring, it will definitely occur. The like of this is concerning the intent of Allah. The like of this, similar to this issue, is that which pertains to the intent of Allah. Allah Azza wa Jal muridun li kulli shay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends, yani, everything, hatta al-mustaqbal alladhi la nihayata lahu, even the future, the endless future. Allah intends that, there is no doubt about it. However, there is a coupled intent, coupled, C-O-U-P-L-E-D, which تكون عند الفعل, takes place with or at the action. This is called الإرادة المقارنة, connected or coupled intention. It is in the saying of Allah, إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون. Here we have two intentions, two wills. إرادة سابقة, a former one, a preceding intent, and وإرادة مقارنة للفعل, and another intent which is in conjunction with the action, coupled to it. So let's see how this is understood. فإذا أراد الله تعالى أن يخلق شيئا, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends to create something, فإنه يريده عند خلقه. This means that he intends it at or when he wants to create it, However, his intent to create in the future, this is not the same as his intent, the coupled intent, and similarly is the knowledge. This is one angle to the answer. The second angle, until we know, حتى نعلم, as in Muhammad, Surah Muhammad 47:31, let's keep it like this, until we know, meaning knowledge upon which there will be recompense, reward or punishment. Because the foreknowledge, the eternal foreknowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the preceding one, لا يترتب عليه ثواب ولا عقاب, is a knowledge upon which there يعني no dependence of recompense. Because reward and punishment يكون بعد الامتحان والابتلاء, because reward and punishment takes place after testing and trials. After, you see the point, and that's where now we can understand, and surely we shall try you till we test those who strive hard. لنعلم حتى نعلم, till we test those who strive hard. And through these angles, alhamdulillah, the problem is resolved, and all praise is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, طيب. The extremists of those who reject the pre-decree of Allah, they say that the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concerning the actions of the slaves is مستأنف or أنف, meaning إن الله لا يعلم الشيء إلا بعد وقوعه, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not know that which pertains to something until after it takes place, after it occurs. There is no doubt that these are kafirs, without any doubt, because they deny what's indicated by the book and the sunnah decisively, and what is also the consensus of the Muslims. This finishes up the rank of al-ilm, of knowledge. Okay, so alhamdulillah ta'ala, we go now to the second rank, which is al-kitaba. Is the matter concerning the knowledge and that issue, is that clear inshallah now? Is that clear? The knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after the occurrence is not the same as his knowledge before its occurrence, because his knowledge before it occurs is a knowledge that it will occur, and his knowledge of it after its occurrence is knowledge that it definitely is occurring.